بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا
عليه
محمد
الصلاة
بن عبد
والسلام.
الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters, welcome back. Today we're going to continue on our series of family values in Islam, the rights of husbands and wives. And with us is as usual, our brother and our Dr. Sayyid Jum'a. Dr. Sayyid Jum'a, welcome back. And we are really, we always look forward, you know, from week to the other to for this beautiful subject to continue and talk. And I want all the people that are listening to us, all the brothers and sisters that are listening to us, to interact and call us. And if you guys have any questions, please keep the phones ringing, and we would love to have the opportunity. It's rare to have a good alim, a good scholar that really knows the subject very well, and he could answer us, with this the knowledge will really spread to everybody. Jazakallah khair, Dr. Sayyid, and welcome back to your program.
Jazakallah khair.
Ahlan wa sahlan.
Jazakallah khair. It's a very important subject, of course, says Magdi, yani, to talk about the life of the husband and the wife. It is, yani, Al-Quran talk about it, and Rasulullah, too many hadith was talking about that. What the purpose of this program, says Magdi, when we talk about the family values in Islam, to make this, inshallah, this life is full of happiness between both of them, and the kids too.
Yes.
And when we talk about the wife, we talk about the husband. We talk about, inshallah, we're going to talk about the kids later on. But we're going to talk about the husband and the wife in the both sides, you know. First of all, our sisters, you have to make your husband very happy.
No.
To try as much as you can to make him happy. To put that happiness in your house. You can create it yourself. يعني you as a sister, you can create the happiness yourself. And also on the same side, we're asking our brother, the husband, to make his wife happy. Too, in the same time. Because ولهن مثل الذي عليهن إيه بالمعروف. بالظبط كده. يعني ما تسألش حقك, don't ask for your right while you're not giving her right. You know? برضو أستاذ مجدي, إن من أسباب السعادة إن الزوجة تحاول تطيع زوجها. يعني try to obey your husband, to be nice to him, and to try to really please him. For instance, some sister, they go outside without telling her husband where I'm going. She's going from a house all the time, says Magdi, without permission from him like that.
No.
I can be fair in that. How I can be fair? For instance, you know, بتاخد إذن عام general permission from him when you go to the Walmart, you go to the in-store, and you go to the doctor.
To buy food.
School, to get the kids to buy food. This is general permission from him. Yeah. But what about if you're going, for example, to a party? Not party, يعني one of your sisters يعني invited you. Not I mean party.
Yeah,
wedding, يعني what I mean. Yeah. You know, something like that. Something, you know, you're going to go, he did not know about it. You have to take permission from him. You have to ask him about it, right? Because
you have to communicate with each other.
Exactly.
And the wife and the husband also let his wife know where he's going.
Where is he? Of course.
And you know, if he has to stay late one day because he's working and everything like that.
But this is Magda, some sister
is very important.
Some sister because if they're jealous more.
Yeah.
She's making like bardo like big bin to
too much
husband.
Control. Yeah.
Too much control.
Yeah, yeah.
Where have you been? Why did not come? I call you. You did not answer. With whom? You know. Too many things. Too many things. Don't control him because you're going to betray him. يعني كده هيتخنق وهيهرب منك ويسيبك.
No, we don't want that to happen. Of
yes,
course.
Yes.
I think mutual respect and it
but
is
from both.
And yes. And this is where really we need to really. This is very important because we live on a society that we really need to do da'wah.
Right.
And we have to show our best. We need to learn our deen. The right way from, you know, and the sunnah of the Prophet.
Yeah,
and we have, and then we need to transform it to our time,
right,
and try to really do the best things.
Yani, brothers, you have to respect your husband, wives too. You have to respect your wives too. Because one of the sisters called me after the program last week. She told me, Sheikh, you know, I was crying when you've been talking with Brother Majdi last week in the program, because my husband treating me like a chair in the house. When I tell him, just, what do you think about that? Do you have no opinion? Shut up, don't talk. You know, she was crying. She said, what are you going to do with him? What can I do with him? He's like that. I told her, make dua for him. Be patient, sister. She said, what do you think? It should be divorced? I said, no. This is what Shaitan wants. Try to be nice with your husband as much as you can. Try to let him understand from the Islamic way. Islamic way. Tell him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said and Rasulullah said. When you tell him Allah and Rasulullah, if he has some kind of iman in his heart, wallahi, the fear of Allah gonna come in his heart, and he's gonna treat you in nice way, inshallah.
نجتمع على ما يرضي الله.
على ما يرضي الله.
نجتمع على ما يرضي الله. We really do everything to make Allah happy with us, and we follow His guidance, and we get away from the things that He and His Prophet have asked us to stay away from.
Yes, says Magdi. لأن في نقطة مهمة, brothers, sisters. إحنا المؤمن smart. You have to be smart too much. And we have to use our mind sometimes, not sometimes, all the time.
Yeah, absolutely.
All the time. Do you know, your husband is working outside. You don't know, sister, what is going on to him in his work. Maybe somebody, you know, giving him hard time.
Yeah. You know,
be patient with him. You're sitting home, jazakallah khair, you're taking care of the kids, jazakallah khair, you're taking care of the house, jazakallah khair. Some sister, they are working with husband too. But, you know, sabr from both of you, but be patient with your husband sometimes, because sometimes when your husband come to the home, you have no patience. You ask him, you're telling him immediately about your problems.
Yeah,
we need that. Let him sit down first. Let him change his clothes first. Let him give him good food.
Start by saying assalamu alaikum. Yes. How are you?
Food, whatever. Are you hungry?
Dua. Inshallah, everything was good. Inshallah.
Yeah. How was your day, habibi?
How was your day?
You're good.
Start with the.
Try to change his mood.
Yeah. Start
from outside.
Then you can speak about that.
With that stress outside, and that bad mood, nervous and kada, and you come and you tell him, you know, this bill comes, you know, somebody sent us, you know, that we're gonna go tonight, we have to spend this money, give me this. The man is nervous, he's coming outside from outside tired, and you already make him treat him a nice way, try to be nice to him, change his mood, to cool him down, feed him, and then كده عودي جنبه يا حبيب قلبي وكذا مش عارف وكلمتين حلوين, وبعدين في وسط العسل الكلام الجميل ده بقى ايه عايزك تقوم ايه اهلا له بقى بالراحه نايس واي ذا واي يو وانت ذا وات يو وانت رايت
يس
اند ابتسم يا اختي, ابتسمي شويه, اتعلمي تبتسمي والله العظيم. دونت تيل مي شيخ اف اي سمايل تو ماي هاسبند اتس حرام. نو اف يو سمايل تو يور هاسبند يو غانا جيت اجر.
صدقه.
نعم. Yeah, if you smile to your sister in Islam, it's sadaqah. If you smile to your husband, this is sadaqah too. Al-mar'a should be smile to her husband. And the man, he loved his wife to smile in his face.
Yes.
And also, you have to smile to your wife. Because some brothers, they are joking outside. Starbucks, coffee bean. Mm. MashaAllah, all the night. Ta-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka. When he came to the house, like this. What is this?
No. No,
what do you think about that?
That's not really acceptable, and you know, everything is based on rahmah. So you need to be wadood. You need to be joking, to be smiling, to enter the house.
Yes.
Enter the house with ease. You know, this is the place that you relax and you want always.
Yes.
The same things that we like. To be, you know, from our wives, our wives also like that from us. To also, you know, go take a shower and relax and wear something clean and put on some perfume and you feel good and your wife will feel good and you have this nice conversation. Alhamdulillah. How was everything? You know, maybe you pray the Maghrib together, you know, and eat together, sit down and eat together with the kids around you and everything. You know, there are time when you can speak about difficulties and this and that. But don't start with difficulties because that could change the whole mood. So go easy. Say alhamdulillah, everything, you know, alhamdulillah, we're sitting together, we're having our kids with us, we're eating together, you know, and this way, this the good atmosphere really, spread over the whole family, you know.
What you say, I like it. Do you know, let me see somebody's calling. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. أختي الكريمة كيف حالك؟
الله رب العالمين.
الحمد لله. What would you like to tell us today إن شاء الله؟ جزاك الله خير.
جزاكم الله خير على البرنامج الرائع، ويا رب الناس كلها يعني تفهم الموضوع اللي حضراتكم بتتكلموا فيه، الرجال فيرست وبعدين النساء. أنا شايفة إن حضراتكم متحاملين قوي على النساء.
لا ما
لا لا لا
احنا بنقول بوث سايد سيستم.
بالعكس انا هلا كنت احكي عن الرجل، انه الرجل ياتي ويكون ضحوك، يكون بشوش،
بس خلينا نرد عليها.
نعم تفضل
اختي الكريمه. المراه هي التي تمثل الحنو والرحمه والحنيه في البيت والتربيه، وهي ملكه البيت. فالراجل شويه دفش، رجاله دفشين صراحه، يعني اقول لك بصراحه كده بالعربي.
دي حاجه مفروغ منها حضرتك، بس عايزه اقول لحضرتك على حاجه. يعني الست مثلا بتشتغل طول النهار، بتتعب مع الولاد، الراجل بره having fun with his friends، لما بيجي بالبيت بيكون زي ما حضرتك قلت مكشر، بيكون مع اصحابه مبسوط، يعني مع اصحابه مبسوط وكده. بس سبحان الله، يعني لو قال لها مثلا جزاك الله خير، الله يعطيك العافيه، اعتقد ان هي مش عايزه منه حاجه ثانيه. الكلمات دي تكفيها وبتريحها من التعب اللي شافته طول النهار.
I agree with you، كلامك صح 100%. يعني the sister she should be patient with her husband during his poverty time. She should be grateful to him during his when he get money or he's rich. And at the same time also the husband, he should be grateful to his wife for about what she's doing at home and serving the community, serving the family.
Family, yeah.
Yeah, I'm serving the community.
And always saying these things what you have said, very important. Very important,
right,
to tell his wife, Jazakallah khair, يعطيك العافية.
معلش أشارك.
اتفضلي يا أختي، اتفضلي.
عايزة أقول بس حاجة، سبحان الله، يعني مرة قرأت لبعض العلماء قالوا حاجة، قالوا إن ربنا سبحانه وتعالى لما خلق حواء ما خلقهاش من رأس آدم حتى لا تتكبر عليه، وما خلقهاش من رجل آدم حتى لا يتكبر عليها.
جميل.
ويحتقرها، بل خلقه. جميل. عز وجل خلقها من ضلع آدم لتكون قريبة من قلبه ليستأنس بها وتستأنس به.
جميل. الله أكبر. جميل جميل. لا ده انت حضرتك ساكنة فين؟ ممكن نجيبك هنا تعملي برنامج. ده انت كلامك حلو قوي.
عزك يا فندم، اقول لحضرتك
كلام كلام علماء يا فندم. الكلام اللي بتقوليه ده ما شاء الله عليك. حضرتك في اي ولايه؟
زوجها بتقول ان زوجها بيعزها جدا وبيحبها وبيحترمها، بس لما بيهزر معاها بيفضل يشتمها.
دي واحده
الهزار والحب اللي من النوع ده يعني.
لا 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 اختي، شوفي خليني اقول لحضرتك على حاجه.
حل الاخوات.
يعني دي واحده اختي بتسال السؤال ده، يعني جوزها بيشتمها؟
لا، هي اتصلت علي من 3-4 ايام قالت لي نفس الموضوع، فقلت لها احمدي ربنا ان هو بيضحك معاكي يعني.
طيب الحمد لله. الحمد لله اللي بيضحك.
لا حول
ولا قوه. في بعض الناس ما بيشتموش.
الشتيم.
الله عنا كل خير، ربنا يتقبل منا ومنكم جميعا. اللهم امين.
من وين الاخت الكريمه؟
الاخت منين؟
الاخت من ولايه ثانيه كده، الله يسهل عليها. من
طيب، جزاك الله خير.
بارك الله
فيك، جزاك الله خير والله. يعني
اتصلي معنا، و يعني المداخله كانت لطيفه.
انا عجبني المعلومه بتاع ضلع ادم دي. نعم. صراحه عجبتني. نعم. جدا. نعم. جزاك الله خير. هي معلومه جديده للمشاهدين صراحه، يعني هي مش جديده عليا ولكن جديد للمشاهدين، بس جزاك الله خيرك انك يعني ذكرتينا فيها. واحنا يعني حاجات زي ديت عايزين المشاهدين، يا ريت يعني زي ما الاخت اتصلت دلوقتي، يا جماعه يا ريت تتصلوا علينا من الولايات وفي كندا، اكيد شايفيننا، واخواننا على تي في تومورو برضو شايفيننا النهارده، يا ريت تتصلوا. ده موضوع جدا، احنا توك شو لايف الان، يعني حاجات مهمه جدا. جزاك الله خير اختنا ديت، يعني ربنا يكرمها.
الله يكرمها.
يعني صراحه معلومه حلوه قوي قوي.
نعم.
يا اخي الكريم، ما عادش تشش مراتك يا اخي، حتى وانت بتهزر خلي هزارك خفيف شويه، بس تقيل كده تشمهاش، قول لها كده يا عسل، يا جميل، يا حلو. يا نجفه، هتقول لك يا عويس، اي حاجه كده.
حلو الاقتصاد يا ويس.
ظبطوا حالكم يعني. مش ايوه على العموم ربنا يا رب يهني بيوت المسلمين كلها.
امين, آمين.
ويكونوا في سعاده وهناء دائما وابدا. جزاكم الله خير. كلمونا يا جماعه يعني توك تو اس شير وذ اس ذا ايشو اوف ذا فاميلي اند ذا فاميلي فاليو ان اسلام. اتس فيري امبورتنت تو كيب اور فاميليز ان شاء الله
ان هارموني
ان هارموني يس
لاف
اكزاكتلي
لاف كومباشن يو نو.
نعم.
اند ذات ويل برينجز ذا فاميلي توجذر اند ريلي ويل برينج ذات you know that blanket of love and happiness to the whole family. The kids will see their mother and their father in tranquility, in complete working together, you know, and loving each other and helping each other, and that will give them, you know, I mean, a good example to how they build their life in the future, because you know happy families always and you know will bring in the kids will be happy and they will be growing in a positive
على الجرح زي ما بيقول.
نعم.
Let us put our hand in the right spot inshallah. Sometimes we see brother Magdi some problems or kind of problems between husband and wife from nothing, start from nothing.
Yeah.
Let me see, somebody's calling and we'll continue inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum assalam wa hayallah bil karam. Umm Yasir, kayfa halukum? Alo, assalamu alaikum.
Ahlin ya mit, marhaba, kif halukum?
Allah yibarik fi hadratik ya rab wa bi ahli kanad al tayyibin. Zay hadratik?
الله يسلمكم الله يحفظكم.
عايزين إضافة حضرتك النهاردة برنامج الحياة الزوجية
للزواج وبالنسبة للعائلات.
اتفضل اتفضل يا أم ياسر.
الحين يعني الزواج صار يعني ما بعرف يعني أحسه أنه يعني بالنسبة للدول الأوروبية الزوجات شايفات حالهم على جزالهم بالنسبة للقانون وبالنسبة للديمقراطية.
أوكي.
أما بالنسبة للميدل إيست الرجال هو اللي شايف على حاله على مرته لأنه عنده الشرع بقول أنا بطلق أنا بأخذ أولادي من 7 سنين أنا بأخذ البنت من 9 سنين ويعني حطتها تحت الأمر الواقع وحطتها يعني شروط يعني ما بعرف يعني مشاكل كثير لكن ترجع هذه يكون هاي المشاكل لو الزوجة عارفة حق الله وبتخاف من الله تعمل حقوقها ولو الرجال خايف من الله وبيعرف الشرع والدين يمشي على حقوقه الاثنين بتمشي السفينة.
أيوة جزاك الله خير يا ياسر.
هذا الكلام يعني الكلام الصحيح 100% إنه both husband and wife, you know, fear God and do things for God's sake. When they do things for God's sake under the umbrella of the Islamic rules and actually this way they satisfy each other and both of them, you know, look forward for a happy life that is governed by Islamic you know rules.
يعني أم ياسر ما شاء الله أم ياسر ريستيلينج أس براذر
أند سيسترز على مخافة رب العباد.
أم ياسر ريستيلينج أس براذر أند سيسترز إن أمريكا سم ويمن they take advantage of the rights by the law American law or Canada or Western law and they take advantage of that they put them their husbands down they are not fearing Allah سبحانه وتعالى and in Middle East like what she said exactly this is what happened exactly she's right. She's saying also that because of the law there, and the husband, they take advantage of the law. They can divorce. They can take the kids. The woman, they have nothing there. And they agree with her. فسبحانallah, Islam, like what Brother Magdi said, لا إفراط ولا تفريط. Just to follow the rights, the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. Quran and Sunnah and Deen. And everybody should follow the right and give the right to each other. حق الزوجة حق الزوجة واجبات وحقوق. يعني أم ياسر حضرتك عندك ايه تاني النهاردة عايزة تقوله لنا بالنسبة للموضوع دهوت in general.
الواحد يعني المودة حلو.
المودة.
المودة. المودة.
أهلا من المودة والحنان والثقة أهم شيء الثقة بين الزوج.
يعني trust between husband and wife and love like what you said the مودة.
يعني مش
كومباشن
على حب. لما نشوف الزوجة والزوج في تبادل حنان وعطف واخذ وعطاء بنجح الجواز بنجح.
نعم
هذا كلام مزبوط. بس
هي حاطه مناخيرها في السماء، انا بدي اتعلم، انا عندي فلوس، وهذاك بقول لا انا بدي انت تضلك قاعده في البيت، انا اخذتني متعلمه، انا ما اخذتني شيء متعلمه من هالكلام هذا يعني.
ايوه
يعني حطت رافع مناخيره بالسماء. طب ولاش الواحد بيتجوز؟
ام ياسر خليني اقول لحضرتك سؤال كده معلش، يعني انت معانا
ان تكون متواضعه بعيده عن الكبر والفخر والخيل.
نعم
يعني
تكون والخيلة. متواضعة. نعم.
والزوج يكون متواضع
بالزبط.
والتنين ينو يجتمعوا على نعم. تفضل
في سؤال. سؤال استاذ مجدي. ام ياسر سؤال لحضرتك الان، لما بتحصل مشكله بين الزوج والزوجه مين السبب؟ يعني انت بتحط اللوم على مين اكتر في 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 في, في المشكله دي؟
احب انا عندي السبب الاساسي الزوج.
الزوج ولا الزوجه؟
الزوج الزوج.
هو مدار الزوج هو بأدي للمرأة كل اللي بدها إياه بتعطيه حنان، مدار هو دفش وما بيعطيش منها منه حنان مش هينجح الجواز.
لا كلام كلام سليم.
صح كلامك
كلام
صح.
سليم 100%.
يعني انت بتأيدي اختنا اللي اتصلت دلوقتي اللي بتقول الزوج سام تايمز بيشتم وبتاع وكلام من ده
يكشر. اه
الزوج هو كل المشاكل منه. إذا أعطى المرأة طيبة، المرأة طيبة. أنا مش عشاني أنا بدي أجي مع الستات، لا المرأة طيبة، المرأة يعني عندها بيت مصنع أولاد طبيخ أكل نظافة. الزوج يعني البيت زي ما البيت زي مصنع الطيران، ما حد بيقدر له البيت.
والله ما حد بيقدر له
جدا.
يس يس أي أجري وديو.
لو الزلمة بيعطيها الحلال وبيعطيها العطف، المرأة طيبة جدا، هي كلها حلال، هي كلها يعني عطف. المرأة بتحن على أخوها، بتحن على أمها، بتحن على ابنها، بتحن على جارها، بتحن على خالتها، بتحن على عمتها، بتحن على جوزها. لكن الزلمة لما يكون قلبه قاسي بتخدم 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 ويكون قلبها قاسي، كيف بدها تحبه
يعني؟ لأم ياسر let me say that in English because you, what you're saying I like it so much. I ask sister Umm Yasir now the brother and sisters, she's what if any problem happened in the house, who caused the problem, the husband or the wife, the man or the lady? She said no, the man, the husband, because the lady or the wife in the house, she's full of love and kindness and mawadda, she loves everybody of the family.
That the way God have created,
created her, exactly like that.
You know, the
yes.
woman, you know, to be,
yes.
to have all these
But she said his
yes.
if he's harsh, diffish, harsh with her, he doesn't know how to treat her, he doesn't know how to deal with her.
He doesn't say kind words, he doesn't
yes.
say kind words to her.
While she's cooking, yeah. she's cleaning, she's teaching, she's serving him, yeah, serving yeah. him, serving yeah. the kids, yeah. serving everybody. Like Masna al-Tayran, like what she said. You know, really, at least if she come back to her, tell her, ya habibti, jazakallah khair, Allah yirda alayki, Rabbana yikhaliyku, kaza. Bardo, I don't need the sister to take advantage of this. She should also to be fair with him, to be grateful to what he's saying. But brother, انت لك القوامة في البيت, you have the قوامة. And part of the قوامة, to treat your wife in a nice way. Yes.
خيركم
لأهله
وأنا خيركم.
That's why رسول الله said it. Why he did not say? جزاك الله خير. يعني أنت اديتنا الفاينل.
ترجع كلها على كل واحد يعرف حقوقه الإسلامية الزوج والزوجة.
أي نعم يا أم ياسر.
ستر الله خير.
ربنا يبارك في حضرتك وشكرا جدا.
ضلك دائما على اتصال معنا يا أم ياسر. بارك الله فيك, حياك الله وجزاك الله ألف خير.
الله يبارك فيك وفي أهل غزة كلهم.
بأهلك وبعيالك.
الله يخليك.
وجميع من حولك.
آمين آمين
ربنا.
جزاك الله خير يا أم ياسر وأختنا اللي اتصلت برضه. ويا ريت يا جماعه تتصلوا علينا دلوقتي, ويا ريت تكلمونا. This is talk show الامين تي في. الحمد لله everybody knows الامين تي في now. الحمد لله everybody watching us around the world. TV tomorrow they are watching us now. الحمد لله. ف let us talk about that. It's very important to know that. Again استاذ ماجد انا كنت بتكلم عن ايه؟ لو في مشكله والمشكله ديت اللي بيكون سببها ام ياسر قالت الزوج صح؟ اي مشكله في البيت, any problem in the house, مين بتكون المشكلة في البداية nothing.
Yeah.
يعني بتطلع بس بالونة صغيرة كده, حاجة صغيرة كده, والشيطان بيقعد ينفخ فيها حتى يخليها بالونة كبيرة جدا بين الزوج والزوجة, مش كده؟
نعم.
خلينا نشوف من المتصل. السلام عليكم. طيب يعني you can call us back إن شاء الله.
إن الشيطان كان الإنسان عدوا مبينا.
بالظبط. وبعدين الشيطان
مبين.
عارفين قصة الإبليس لما نادى للشياطين وقال لهم أنا لو اللي هيعمل عمل بأسود مع أولاد آدم النهاردة أنا هلبسه التاج. واحد قال أنا خليت واحد زينة. قال له والتاني يقول أنا خليت واحد قتل. وقال له حيتوب، والتاني مش عارف ايه كذا. واحد قال له انا خليت واحد اتطلق من مراته النهارده. قال له انت اللي هتلبس التاب اذا كنت هتخرب بقى البيوت المسلمين، هو ده اللي انا عايزك تعمله.
هذه هو
فيعد ده ابليس، هي جيف ذا تاج ذا 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 كراون تو وان اوف ذا شيطانز because he divide a man from his wife, he make he caused them to divorce each others,
because in Islam is in Islam husband and wife
has value,
family is the nucleus of Islam, and it is very important, and we really should work very hard in bringing husband and wife and teaching
مع بعض، يعني بيشتغلوا مع بعض عشان البيت وعشان الاولاد يعني.
بالظبط، بس في اسباب فعلا لغت شخصية زوجات، وممكن في حالات ان في حاجات وحشه جدا حاصله، ولكن العملية لازم تكون في بالانس بين الطرفين، وكلهم ماشيين بهدف ان هم عايزين يوصلوا للجنه واولادهم ويقودوا الحياه بما قال ربنا عليه.
بالظبط كده يا حاجه، يعني the husband and the wife they are working together not against each others. They are working together for the sake of Allah. They married by the name of Allah.
نعم.
And they for the kids, for the family, for the house. نعم. That this is safina like a ship. نعم. They are working. If they're gonna be against each other, they're gonna drown.
Yes,
you
drown. Know?
Absolutely. Gonna drown.
حتة المصلحة، أنا شايفة دلوقتي الحياة بقت مصلحة قوي، فبقت المصلحة دي في كل اعتبار، في كل حتى في الحياة الزوجية. فلازم الناس تتجرد من الموضوع دي شوية.
أيوة.
تتجرد. ترجع لربنا وتشوف بنرضي الله، عشان إحنا عايزين الجنة مش عايزين وقت التجارب.
نعم.
Exactly يا حاجة، we need الجنة والله، we need it.
We need to help each other, husbands and wife, to help each other to attain جنة.
بالضبط.
You know, and بارك الله فيك. إيش السؤال تبعك؟ السؤال اسألي تفضلي يا أختي.
هي فتوى الحياة وأنا محتاجة الفتوى دي.
تفضلي.
الحاجة اللي أنا عايز أقول، لو في حد عنده بيت متأجر وهو بيغطي نفسه كويس، والبيت التاني حضرتك عارف إن إحنا في أمريكا في نظام المورجج والحاجات دي. حتة كلمة ربا كلمة خطيرة جدا. لو الإنسان بيعمل كل حاجة كويسة، برسالة القرآن، بيحاول يعمل ما في وسعه عشان يحصل على الجنة ويرضي ربه، حتة السكن اللي هو فيه ده حاجة مش بإيده، يعمل فيها إيه؟ حتة المورجج
والله أنا هقول لك كلام العلماء، يعني الشيخ القرضاوي يعني رجل يعني حلل في بلاد الويسترن سوسايتي فيرست مورجج، هي سيد از اوكي بيكوز الفيرست مورجج اللي هو البيت اللي انت هتسكني فيه از اوكي. ليه؟ لان انت عندك يور برايفسي، عندك يور فاميلي، عندك تو ميني ثينجز. فور اكزامبل ايماجين لايك سمبادي هاز جاست جيرلز اند هي ليف ان ابارتمنت، ذات ابارتمنت has too many things against Islam, and between apartment and another apartment just like wood wall, you know, from wood.
Too many common too many common spaces, common everybody gets there and people get, you know.
Yes, and no privacy, no privacy actually.
No privacy, yeah.
For him and his family. That's very important, you know, to have your own home, your privacy, your family, your too many things. That's why Sheikh Al-Qaradawi, يعني ربنا يجزيه الخير, when he said that fatwa, he said it, if you read the book of مقاصد الشريعة أصول الفقه اسمي الشريعة أصول الفقه, you will understand that الضرورات تبيح المحظورات ودرء المفسد أوجب من جلب المصلحة. يعني too many things, you know, وأخف الضررين وأولى لك فأولى. Too many things, you know, rules of the شريعة, from it the scholar they take the fatwa. It is not because we are living. No, it is not like that. We have rules, we have foundation of our studying in Islam, we give fatwa related to that rules in Islam, we depend on it, يعني بنعتمد عليها. لما بنعطي فتوى بقصد الشريعة بنخف الضررين الأصول الفقهية الأصول الفقه حاجات كتيرة قوي يعني.
ويعني في الوقت الحاضر ما فيش بنوك إسلامية
يعني واحد دلوقتي الحاجة اللي احنا بنقولها ان لما يكون حد غصب عنه واضطر يعني موف to another house عشان في حاجه في تايم معين لحاجه
وهي كانسل. اوكي حاجه ان شاء الله. فيرست مورجج اوكي ان شاء الله. الله يجزاكم الخير ربنا يبارك في حضرتك ان شاء الله.
سؤال كمان ما نشفت اذنك. في حد عليه دين يعني حد دين وعايز ان الدين ده يقضى عنه وحد عايز يدفع زكاه، يجوز ان الفلوس بتاع الزكاه دي تروح للي هو اللي عليه دين كمساعده ليه ولا لا؟
طب يعني هو عنده فلوس والفلوس ده هيدفع لها زكاه مش كده؟
لا شخصين، شخص عليه دين وفي شخص تاني عايز يدفع فلوس زكاه.
نعم.
ممكن فلوس الزكاه ده
والغارمين يس اوف كورس طبعا هي تجوز ان شاء الله.
يعتبر فك
افتكرت.
والغارمين والغارمين وفي سبيل الله يا الغارمين، ما هو غارم هو راجل
عليه دين،
عليه دين. الزكاة مصارف الزكاة 8 ما ربنا ذكر فيهم الغارمين، صح ولا لا؟
تمام.
اي نعم، بارك الله في حضرتك ان شاء الله. I think somebody was calling. Yeah, somebody was calling. Inshallah, call back.
Call back. We are going to have. Yeah. We're going to go to a break, and we are going to be back. Please call us after the break. Jazakum Allah al khair. Assalamu alaikum. Stay with us. We're going to have a short break, and we'll be back.
Inshallah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome back, brothers and sisters. We have a small break. We're gonna be talking again at family values in Islam.
Inshallah.
حقوق, the rights of زوج husband زوج. And wife in the family environment.
We're gonna continue.
Yes, Dr. Sayyid Jum'a, بارك الله فيك.
Go ahead. خير. يعني for the sisters, especially sister, my advice to you: when you go out from your house, don't put a lot of perfume and a lot of things like that. This is haram. One sister asked me, Sheikh, what about that thing, you know, that she put it under that her label to kaza.
Yeah.
عشان الريحة. Okay, but if don't put any perfume has no. Refragrance or ريحة, you know, people can smell you.
Not strong. Yeah, strong, yeah. Strong.
And yeah. Also very important, while you're home, اهتم بنفسك شوي. هندامك. خليك دايما ريحتك حلوة لجوزك كذا. وانت كمان. خلي ريحتك حلوة لزوجتك كمان. يعني. يعني
البس تعطى البس. البس حلو في البيت خذ شاور بعد ما ترجع من الشغل تيك شاور هون it's very available you know you can take a shower
and away. انه احب ان اتزين لزوجتي كما تحب هي ان تتزين لي.
نعم.
يعني ابن عباس said I would like to fix myself to my half a wife like exactly what she's doing for me. فمهم او يعني الموضوع ده امر مهم برضه من الاشياء اللي خصوصا للسيسترز انت تبتعدي عن البدع والسحر والسحره والمشعوذين
أيوة
لان
أيوة.
ذلك يخرج عن المله وهلاك ومضيعه في الدنيا والاخره. سيسترز بي اواي فروم ذا جارو ذات فورشن تيلرز بيكوز ذيس از غانا بي اوت اوف الاسلام اف يو دو ذات. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سيد اف يو جو تو اني magician or fortune teller people and you believe about what you're doing you're gonna be out of Islam. فقد كفر بمنزل على محمد.
I think even if you don't believe you just go.
No, if you don't believe let me say it.
تفضل.
Yeah. If you don't believe just you go just once while you don't believe in him Allah will not accept your salah for 40 days. This hadith
very important.
Yeah. Yes.
Even you think it's for fun you
for
know
fun. I'm doing exactly. You know, this. Exactly.
Yeah, yeah,
exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
برضو يا سيستر really don't and I'm asking sister and the brother too if with any problem they go to that fortune teller they go to for this مهراجة or بهراجة or فهراجة كلام فاضي هذا أقول له and you know if these people they know and the unseen if they know the unseen they have to be richest people in the world
yeah.
And they're begging you for $5 يعني سبحان الله فهذا مهم قوي. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
عليكم السلام.
حياكم الله أختي الكريمة كيف حالكم؟
الحمد لله.
سؤال حضرتك ايه النهارده معانا؟
نور من بصله.
اهلا وسهلا يا اخت نور زي حضرتك.
I have a question. There's this show on TV and like she's like she like talks to the dead and I don't believe it but I watch it. Is that haram?
Talk to the what?
What TV? Not our TV of course, right?
Oh no, it's on American TV.
Oh, they talk to the dead people, right?
Yeah.
No, this is not right. They talk to the shayateen. The one who's claiming.
Is it haram? Is it haram to watch though?
I'm not telling you haram to watch it. It's everything in the TV now. But my advice to you, it's better to if you see something like that, be away from it and don't watch it because this is gonna corrupt your aqidah, your faith, you know. First of all, nobody can talk to the dead people. الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم they used to walk with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم between the graves. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said لولا ألا you understand the Arabic right?
Yeah.
إيه قال لولا ألا تدافنوا لأريتكم من عذاب القبور أو من عذابهم. The only one he can know what's going on in the graves. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Even Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم he did not talk to the dead people. And Allah said in the Quran إنك إن لا يستوي الأعمى والبصير ولا الظلمات ولا النور ولا الظل ولا الحرور ولا يستوي الأحياء ولا الأموات إن الله يسمع من يشاء وما أنت مسمع من في القبور.
نعم.
إن أنت إلا نذير. خلي أجيب لك الدليل يعني. فإن أنت إلا نذير. Nobody can talk with the dead people. This is شيطان. even if this did people they give information, this is shaitan. Every, you know, I have Qareen, you have Qareen, right?
Yeah.
That Qareen is still alive. After my death, my Qareen gonna still alive, gonna be alive. Because the jinn, they live hundreds of years. And that Qareen, he knows a lot of things about me because he used to go with me, right?
Yeah.
And this magician people, they can get that Qareen of me, they can talk with him, and that Qareen, he can tell them some information about me, and he can copy my voice too. This is what they're doing. It's called Tanasq al-Arwah. تناسق الارواح ويجيب واحد قرين واحد ميت وزي صوته بالظبط ويقول لك ده بيتكلم ورجع اهو ابويا رجع اهو وبتاع وهو ما رجعش ولا حاجه ده الشيطان اللي كان معاه
نعم
ف too many things in our عقيده ابن تيميه رحمه الله وسمسكر they talk about that يعني ف it's better to be away from that because this is against our عقيده ان شاء الله
ما شاء الله you are a very beautiful young lady use your time in a good way. You could be a da'iya, you could be learning about
you know. Is any question, Sister Noor, inshallah?
No, thank you.
خير. Thank you, sister. Let me see somebody's talking. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Hayyakum Allah, brother, welcome. How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
What's your beautiful name and where are you calling from?
My name is Muhammad Nadir Shriki. I'm calling from Pomona.
Welcome.
First of all, I would like to thank you and appreciate Al Amin TV for such a beautiful show. And secondly, this is a great opportunity for us as a Muslim. Alhamdulillah that we have, this is a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed to the partners through the effort of our respected brothers, sisters, they are putting a lot of efforts in all these shows for us. And as a Muslim, we need to take the full advantage and opportunity of this, and we need to learn from this in the educational information TV. As well as also, this is our responsibility. We need to support and contribute our full support with this Al Amin TV, inshallah. May Allah make it easy and for all of us, may Allah guide us to obey the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the footsteps of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazakum Allah khair, doctor, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really accept from you and all of us, brother Majdi. مشاهدين إن شاء الله our viewers and we're trying إن شاء الله to educate our community really with our right way of Islam with the moderation of Islam الحمد لله and إن شاء الله جزاكم الله خير إن شاء الله we hope to see you soon doctor إن شاء الله جزاكم الله خيرا
thank you so much for your attention for from all of جزاكم الله خير
حياكم
الله وعليكم ورحمة الله
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته
وعليكم السلام جزاكم الله خير دكتور for calling and يعني reminding all of our brothers and sisters about supporting Al Amin TV. And I hope Brother Mustafa to put that inshallah. We ask you to be a member of Al Amin TV with $10 a month, right, Mrs. Magdi?
Yes.
And or $100 a year. This is for keeping this da'wah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sadaqah jariya.
No.
For somebody, sadaqah jariya for somebody you love, sadaqah jariya for somebody you're giving him some gift and hasanat inshallah. We ask you for that $10 a month and $100 inshallah a year. That's nothing. You know, if I came to your house, you invite me for some food, or Brother Majdi, you're gonna maybe spend more than that.
Yeah, cup of coffee. You know, daily we spend.
But
$10.
This is gift for somebody in his grave.
At least we buy 2 cups of coffee sometimes. Yes. And
somebody in his grave, sadaqa jariya, ilman allamah, ilman allamah, ilm that ilm you spread it. You spread it, you give it to others. Alhamdulillah, we're doing that on behalf of everybody.
Yeah, and we,
just support us because we need really some support to pay this bill this month, and, like $11,000. Yeah. May Allah help, inshallah.
And we want to be able to do even more.
Right,
you know, we just started, and we want to continue doing much better, inshallah, with your help, with your support. Keep on calling us, keep on supporting us, keep on sending, you know, all your, I mean, anything, you know, your suggestions on things that we can do. Jazakumullah al khair.
We are actually in, Brother Magdi, in Alhamdulillah, from today's in TV Tomorrow. TV Tomorrow, this satellite, mashallah, all Arab channels from Egypt, Saudi Arabia, all over the world, everywhere in that satellite, mashallah, TV Tomorrow. It's beautiful. And 7 Islamic channels from Egypt and from Saudi Arabia, Al-Majd. And you are the only one in America in this TV Tomorrow now. Yeah. In English, alhamdulillah, for our community in America and Canada. The one, of course, Islamic alhamdulillah, TV, and in moderation way, very important. Yeah. Alhamdulillah, we're talking in behalf of our Islam and deen from that knowledge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to us. Yes. The point is, when I look to the TV Tomorrow and I see the channels, mashallah, very high quality. These people, they have millions of dollars to support their channels. Yeah. We are the only channel there. We are not poor. Alhamdulillah, our sheikhs very strong in English.
Yes.
And they are very strong in their education. Mm. Alhamdulillah, we are educating the kids, or we have special programs. But the point is that Kamaliyat, we don't have it. For example, we need somebody for editing to make something here between the programs and all of that, because I feel the programs is still broken because we don't have money. And if I have 10th of that money this channel they have, I gonna make oof, يعني big
beautiful
channel.
Work.
Beautiful work.
Beautiful work. Yes.
We need your support. Well, you know, I'm sure somebody is watching. He can, for the sake of Allah, donate some money to say, Sheikh, I want you to hire somebody for editing, to invent, to make, create some different programs.
And we're gonna be doing so many different things, having
for the kids, for
some episodes, you know, halakat, you know, exactly, you know, things, Islamic history, you know, a lot of things that we can.
It's da'wah,
for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other beautiful thing that we are starting doing, we're doing a lot of teachings and a lot of, you know, family nights from the masajid, you know, and Brother Jum'ah. Brother says Jum'ah is you know, taking the camera over there and to different masajid all around. And we want also a lot of the imma to send, maybe if they have good
DVDs. We invite also the leaders, Brother Magdi, of the community.
Yes.
Alhamdulillah, we've been inviting the mayor of Palmdale, great man.
Yeah.
And we invite the very great man, I love this him so much, our leader also here in the United States of America, Los Angeles, the Sheriff Lori Baca.
Lee Baca, yeah.
Yeah, Baca is a great man, mashallah.
Yeah.
And mashallah, we're willing to invite, inshallah, next week with Brother Kamal Khatib, mashallah, Jazallah Khair for his effort to keep, to build bridges and to fill that gap as Muslim community and non-Muslim, even Arab and non-Muslim and non-Arab also,
in the United States,
to the leaders, with the leaders, Sheikh. It's very important to really think about that. We're trying to bring the community together, to educate the community in our beautiful way, alhamdulillah, with a good smile of Razan Majdi, mashallah. You cannot say Sheikh like this. Jazakallah khair.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. No, there is, you know, the future is ours. The future is Islam. The future is, but we need your help so we can have these programs. We have bigger, better programs that we can bring to you. And inshallah, we will continue slowly but surely, inshallah.
Inshallah. Jazakallah khair, Sheikh. Let's talk, continue, Sheikh Magdi. Jazakallah khair, Sheikh Magdi, about that. And sister, when you go out, because I live with you here in the country, Brother Magdi, everybody knows that. I'm not saying something is not happening. Some sister, I'm not saying intentionally. Maybe accidentally, maybe she did not, يعني, مش واخدة بالها, يعني. When she get out from her house to go outside, she's a lot of fashion, you know, moda, and you know, her
fashion,
hijab,
yeah, too much,
fashion.
Yeah.
Her hijab needs another hijab.
No.
You know?
No.
She's wearing jeans tight while she's putting hijab in her hair. She's opening this area while this, that doesn't work.
It doesn't go together.
Yes. Sister, يعني, try to moderate, balance your hijab. Well, hijab al-Islami, I'm not telling you, I'm wearing a shirt, alhamdulillah. See, I'm not wearing like abaya, ولا المهم. This is not the point. The point is
modesty.
لا يشف ولا يصف. For the man and the woman. For men and women in Islam. Your hijab, your clothes should not be tight. Losing like this. She's not be tight and she's, you cannot see through it, you know, it's not very خفيفة يعني
thin. Translucent.
Exactly.
No translucent material.
To see your body or something.
No translucent materials. Nothing that is so tight, so it will show your body and you know wearing jeans and all that. Try to get away from that.
She can wear jeans, but not tight.
Yes.
Yes. What's wrong with that? Yeah. If her clothes is not tight, it's okay. What's wrong with that? You know, especially some sisters that are working nowadays. She cannot wear jilbab and go her work. You know, doesn't. يعني, too many different types. It depends about what kind of work she's doing. But the point is, my brother too, when your wife going outside your daughter or something, ask her, yeah, please, could you fix this hair, fix this hijab, fix this. This is your duty, brother. You know, this is your duty. فمهمة قوي. And sister, تكوني بسيطة مش متكلفة في لبسك ومظهرك وزينتك. يعني اللباس الشرعي زي ما علمائنا قالوا لا يصف ولا يشف ولا يكن زينة في نفسه.
نعم.
زينة في نفسي يعني some sister بقى ما شاء الله two many different colors and she's telling people look at me I'm here.
Yeah.
Your hijab, your clothes should be simple. Very simple.
Modest.
Simple. بسيط. You know, not too many things. And you yourself, brother and sister, both. Be simple. ما تبقاش متكلف كده وتقعد بقى أصلني وأصل فصلي وعشان وإيوه وقعد بقى أعمل لي بكتافك كده وبتاع. ما doesn't work like that. خليك خفيف وخليك بسيط وخليك انسان كده طيب سبحان الله وما تقعدش تتحجر لان الناس مش هبله دلوقتي ما عادش حد اهبل اذا كنت انت بتستهبل الناس مش هبله يا عمي ده ابنك الصغير في البيت your little kid is not you know he will understand what you're doing he's understanding what you're doing nobody يعني foolish now everybody understand everybody فسبحان الله don't belittle people don't put them down because maybe they are better than you But you don't know. Because if you're ignorance, you're thinking that, no, don't belittle anybody. Put yourself down to Allah and His people, you know? And be away from your ego. And also, sister and brother. Brother and sister, both. Oh, sisters, and I say both. لا تسمح لأحد يا أستاذ مجدي أن يتدخل في حياة الزوج والزوجة الشخصية. يعني
مهمة جدا.
نعم. Don't let anybody to interfere in your life, brother and sister. Yeah. Your uncle, your father, your mother, they come to interfere and to say opinion and too many things. And they cannot corrupt your home for the husband and the wife and the kids should be away from people. Especially the secret sister. Don't tell anybody. Yes.
You should resolve it with your husband.
Yes.
You know, sit down. And this is something that is very private. So don't let anybody, if you think that maybe somebody's going to help you, unfortunately, we know that if anybody interfere, they're gonna make the problem even bigger.
More
and then it's very hard to resolve it. So
and if your husband travel, sister, or your brother, yeah, most of the husband traveling, yeah, يعني both. Inshallah, if your sister traveling, see her family. المرأة جنة الرجل ونار. أنت ممكن تحطي خاتم في صباعك. رجل برضو زي ما مياسر قالت الست طيبة. والله الرجل طيب. بس أنت كمان عمليه برضو بحنية شوية. هو بحب كده. هو راجل هو دفش انت حاول بقى الدفشه دي لينيها انت شويه بس انت اللي قوامه البيت في ايدك
نعم.
بقى وانت شاطره بقى وانت اللي ما شاء الله مش قصدي قوامه البيت القوامه مع الراجل بس اللي انا بقصد انت الكل في الكل انت رئيس المصنع ايوه انت رئيس البيت
ايوه
يعني فانت بس كلمه حلوه حنيه منك كده طبطبي على ظهره كده وبتاع يا حبيب قلبي يا عيني ده انت من احنا من غيرك ولا حاجه وناقصنا كم مليون حاجه يا حبايب وحشتوني حاجات كده من الاغاني القديمه دي ايوه كده حاجات حلوه كده الاغاني ظبطيه كده بيظبط ودايما ابتسمي وتفائلي الحاجات ديت وبعدين اياكي ثم اياكي ان تنقضيه النقد اللاذع على كل صغيره وكبيره don't buy it with each thing small and big why you did that you should do that and you like that and that sometimes you're gonna get tired and you're gonna say guys I will leave you alone I don't wanna listen to anybody he's gonna give you his back and he's gonna hit you with the wall مش عايز يكلمك خلاص فانت لا ما توصليش مع جوزك للدرجه دي وبرده استاذ مجدي
the same thing with the brothers to the sisters
of course both yeah. I'm talking yeah. Yeah, brother sister both when I say something about somebody this both yeah. both side قال اياك والغيره والشك ده دي بقى for sisters mostly the sister they get jealous
but also brothers some والشك. Brothers are very very jealous and they you do do they I mean they really that's us both
but mostly yeah. sister My sister, they think her husband loves somebody
else. How do you know, your Sheikh? You are not a sister.
But I know from I've been in the masajid. I've been in too many problems between families. They come to me to make consultation. Yeah. That's why I know the problem.
Okay.
You know, the problem started because sisters mostly she loves her husband. Alhamdulillah, كتير.
Yes.
فبتيجي بقى في النهاية ما تلاقي بس بتكلم واحدة أو غير التون بتاعته. يا أخي ما جوزك لازم يحترم الناس. يعني your husband should respect people when he talk to them. Maybe sister when he's talking to somebody, she said, "Why you're not talking to me like this way? We're talking to the people like سبحان الله عند أوهام بقى. الظنون comes to her mind.
الشيطان بخش.
الشيطان also بينفخ فيها blowing too much.
Of these small balloons. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And the man also shout when you're gonna shout, yelling to each others, and gonna be another problem. فأنت لازم تثق في زوجك. You have to trust your husband.
Yes.
I mentioned in my book this is سعادة الزوجية too many things for the husband and wife really. But you have also brother, you have also sister. To understand the قداسة الربية الزوجية الميثاق الغليظ the big and big and the big and big covenant Allah سبحانه وتعالى gave it to you and from Allah between you and her سبحان الله and you have to think millions of times brother and sister before you make divorce or any problem because this is what الشيطان wants from you to destroy your
that family.
Family.
Yeah, destroy the family.
نعم وهذه أشياء مهمة جدا جدا برضو احذر يا سيستر Be aware, be careful from your friends because mostly sisters, she's telling her friends about women they like to talk too much. They have time at home to talk in
but
the phone.
Really should,
and
not, should not, should not.
Don't tell the secret of the home to anybody.
Private issues.
Private issues to anybody.
Not to anybody.
Even if he's very close to you.
Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah. And also don't fight. Let me see somebody's calling. Rabbi Buster. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum. السلام عليكم طيب call back إن شاء الله maybe something wrong with the line call back إن شاء الله some sister and some brother too when the problem comes they said كرامتي كبريائي oh, my honor my كبرياء who am I you know they think like this way a brother تنازل take it easy no she doesn't know who am I and also the family another family said they doesn't know and this is what the shaitan want and sister if any problem happened between you and your husband
no.
don't escape from the house
no
don't run away from the house
no
do you think when you go away from the house this is the easiest way to solve the problem no if you leave your house this is a big problem
no
shaitan gonna make it big and more and more.
You stay at home. Don't leave. You can stay in your room.
No.
And do du'a. You know, and sit down. Maybe you do wudu. Pray a couple of ruk'ah lillahi ta'ala.
Exactly.
And inshallah things will be resolved.
Something related to the family. Both families, the family of the wife. If any one of them came to the house, for example, brother, for you. If the family of your wife comes to visit you in your house, you have to welcome them in a nice way, respect them. Mm-hmm. Show your wife you're treating her family in a very nice way.
Yeah.
Don't think when you talk badly or about that.
تشخط لما تشخط فيها قدام أهلها.
لا كمان even if you talk badly about her family, do you think that she will forget that for you? No. Maybe if you insult her.
She's gonna say the same thing about your family.
Exactly.
Too.
Maybe if you insult her. Or say bad thing to her, she's gonna forgive it to you. But her family, no. Don't insult her family. If they come to your house, treat them in a nice way. Sister, you are the most. If the family of the husband came to visit you in your house, try to show them all kind of kindness and love and good generosity.
Yes.
With beautiful names, call them special hamatik, your mother-in-law, hamati malak. لازم تخ... هي أمك أصلا. ما هي اللي جابت لك جوزك. يعني فيها ايه لما تعملها كويس بالظبط كده مش كده
وبعدين
هيحبك والله
دائما 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 تكون ناصحه لزوجها
yes.
دائما تذكره في قرابه في القرابه وفي وصلة
الرحم
وصلة الرحم نعم
الأخير.
نعم
yes.
نعم
ايوه ليه يا استاذ مجدي انا اي لايك ذس جزاك الله خير والله اي لايك ذس دو يو نو واي ذا سام سيستر ذي سيد when the kids they came and they talk about his uncle, for example, the husband's brother, uncle, you know, uncle.
Yeah.
They said, no, خالك مش عمك. See, they call him uncle too.
Yeah.
Uncle
yeah.
from her side, you know.
Yes.
Her brother.
Her brother.
Yeah. Yes. Said, I love my uncle. I love you. I want to go visit him. No. Let's go to your uncle, another uncle. Her خاله يعني مش عمه خاله. ليه؟ سبحان الله. She wants all the kids to love her family, not the family of the husband. This is not right.
It's not right. Yeah,
yeah. ولكن الولد طلع لخاله ودي الولد لأبوه مش عارف.
كل الولد لخاله.
وبتاع لا يا جماعة الخير.
كل بوليتكس هذا.
كل بوليتكس. Even in the family, no politics.
No.
You have to love, balance if
yes,
your life.
Balance your life. Yes.
Sister, you are responsible. You are responsible. You are responsible, and him too. But I'm telling you, sister. For bringing your kids in Islam, raising them in Islamic way. ما تهمليش أولادك. جوزك بيشتغل برا. He's working outside. All the day outside. You are the one who's sitting home. Take care of your kids. Take care of your kids. Take care of your kids. And also don't talk badly about your husband while he's not at, in his absence, while he's not home.
Yes.
Some sister, when she get problem with her husband, she's telling her kids, about, look what your dad did. It's bad, you know. You put your husband yeah, down front of the kids. Haram. Haram.
And the same thing, the husband doesn't have.
Same thing. Same thing, the husband.
Wife, yes.
See, wallahi al-azim.
Balance.
Yeah. Also, inshallah, we're going to talk later on about, about inshallah.
MashaAllah, in Islam, there are answers to every question. There are ways that the Prophet, peace be upon him, and the Quran have taught us how to have these relationships to God. And the Salaf and the Sahaba, and we're so rich. Islam is so rich in these relationships and telling us what to do and respect the, you know, the sisters, the your wives, you know. It says they are qawarir, they are, you know,
qarura.
Naam. They are so valuable. They are the gems of the society, and we really need to work together as a family to understand and to follow the rules that God subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have put for us, and we have agreed to follow these rules. And if we follow those rules, we will never be astray, and we live a very happy and successful life as husband and wife, as a family,
yes,
raising our children, inshallah. And
finally, let me also tell you something. I'll leave
and a small dua,
inshallah,
for the whole family,
inshallah.
And we here, Muslims in the United States and Canada.
Yeah, brother and sister, let me tell you, inshallah, the final about that. Inshallah, next time, me and brother Magdi, jazallah khair, brother Majd al-Bitar, we're going to talk about the bringing kids in Islam. And this is very important, inshallah. Yeah. One of my books, actually, according to the way of the Quran and the Sunnah. But sister, help your husband. Brother, help your wife. And sister, seek al-akhirah, like what you seek in dunya. Brother, seek al-akhirah more than you seek in dunya. And don't think this dunya has no problems in the families, in the homes, between the families, husband and wife. No, that's normal, very normal. If you think you are in problem, you have problem with your wife,
no,
this is not the end. This is normal جداً. And I consider it like the spicy in the food. Do you put some salt in the food, right?
Yeah.
If you put too much, you cannot eat. If you did not put, you cannot eat. Like the spice and some salt, you know?
Yeah.
These problems, you know, gonna bring you back together.
Yeah.
Yes, with full of love, because you cannot go away from each other. Because you already been husband and wife too many years. Love each other more. Love your society. Love your kids. Love yourself first. If you did not love yourself, you will not love your wife and your society and the family, inshallah.
We're going to make a small commercial. I think this Saturday you're going to be in Glendale. The family night in Glendale, 700 Adam Street in Glendale, the Islamic Center of Glendale. The Sheikh is going to be there giving, we're going to have dinner, you know, starting at 6 o'clock, 6:30, and then Maghrib. And
Saturday,
after Maghrib, we are going to have a nice teach. You know, you're gonna have a nice program.
Inshallah.
You're gonna teach and
for the family, know, bring your
and family, in. Bring your family to Glendale Islamic Center.
What about Friday?
Friday, you are going to be at Reseda as usual. You know, inshallah.
Reseda Masjid, inshallah, same time, 7:30,
until
inshallah Salat al Isha, 9 o'clock. Bismillah, bring your family, bring your kids, bring everybody to see the masjid Friday night.
Yeah.
the family, alhamdulillah, before 2 years, beautiful, with being doing that, last Friday, we did not find the space for everybody, mashallah. Maybe we're going to go to New Masjid this week. Yeah. Try to bring everybody. Come, we love you all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. This, we will learn something, inshallah. You, at least you will see everybody.
Tell your friends, we'll make dua for you, you know, and inshallah. Come and learn and learn. And if you have any questions, Dr. Sayyid Jum'a is going to be there. He have a specific time for questions and answers. And it will be also put on TV. We're going to continue, you know, really in our, in all our, you know, efforts to bring you the best. Jazakumullah alf khair.
Make dua, inshallah.
Thank you very much. Go ahead.
Let's make dua for you and us and Brother Magdi and Brother Mustafa. We're going to fix the sound now, inshallah. We'll make dua. Inshallah. Say ameen with me, inshallah. Maybe Allah will accept it from us. Ameen. Inshallah.
Ameen.
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم إنا نسألك خير المسألة وخير الدعاء وخير النجاح
آمين.
وخير العلم
آمين.
خير العمل خير آمين. الثواب آمين. وخير الحياة
آمين.
وخير الممات. وثبتنا وثقل موازيننا آمين. وحقق إيماننا وارفع درجاتنا آمين. وتقبل صلاتنا
آمين.
واغفر خطيئاتنا ونسألك الدرجات العلى من الجنة يا رب العالمين.
آمين.
اللهم إنا نسألك فواتح الخير وخواتمه
آمين.
وجوامعه وكوامله وأوله وآخره
آمين.
وظاهره وباطنه والدرجات العلى من الجنة. اللهم نجينا من النار واغفر لنا مغفرة بالليل والنهار
آمين.
يا رب العالمين نسألك خلاصا من النار
آمين.
اللهم ادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار
آمين.
حمنا فإنك بنا راحم
آمين.
ولا تعذبنا فإنك علينا قادر. ولطفنا يا مولانا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم إنا نسألك أن ترفع ذكرنا وتضع وزرنا وتصلح أمرنا
آمين.
وتطهر قلوبنا وتحصن فرجنا وتنور لنا في قبورنا وتغفر لنا ذنبنا ونسألك درجات من الجنة العلى يا أرحم الراحمين
آمين. آمين.
اللهم إنا نسألك أن تبارك لنا في أسماعنا وفي أبصارنا وفي أرواحنا وفي خلقنا وفي خلقنا وفي أهلينا وفي مالنا وفي محيانا وفي مماتنا وفي عملنا. اللهم وتقبل حسناتنا نسألك الدرجات العلى من الجنة. اللهم اجعل أوسع رزقك علينا عند كبر سننا وانقطاع عمرنا. يا من لا تراه العيون ولا تخالطه الظنون ولا يصفه الواصفون ولا تغيره الحوادث ولا يخشى الدوائر يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين
آمين.
رحمة عدد قطر الأمطار وعدد ورق الأشجار وعدد
آمين.
ما أظلم
آمين.
عليه الليل وأشرق عليه النهار
آمين.
ولا تواري منه سماء سماء ولا أرض أرضا ولا بحر ما في قعره ولا جبل ما في وعره. اجعل خير عمرنا آخرة وخير أعمالنا خواتمة
آمين.
وخير أيامنا يوم نلقاك يا أرحم الراحمين
آمين.
يا ربنا يا ربنا اغننا اغننا بغناك وارحمنا برحمتك ادخلنا الجنة يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعلنا صبورين واجعلنا شكورين واجعلنا يا رب العالمين من عبادك المؤمنين. أكرمنا في الدنيا والآخرة وارحمنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. نسألك علما نافعا وعملا متقبلا ورزقا حلالا طيبا. اللهم إنا نستغفرك لذنوبنا ونستهديك لمراشد أمرنا نستجيرك من شر أنفسنا ونتوب إليك فتوب علينا إنك أنت ربنا يا الله. اللهم فاجعل رغبتنا إليك صدرنا وبارك لنا فيما رزقتنا وتقبل منا. اللهم أنت ربنا يا من أظهر الجميل وستر علينا القبيح يا من لا يؤاخذ بالجريرة ولا يهتك الستر يا عظيم العفو يا حسن التجاوز يا واسع المغفرة يا باسط اليدين بالرحمة ويا صاحب كل نجوى يا منتهى كل شكوى يا كريم الصفح يا عظيم المن يا مبدئ النعم قبل استحقاقها يا ربنا ويا سيدنا ويا مولانا ويا غايتنا ورغبتنا. نسألك ألا تشوي خلقنا بالنار يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك من فضلك ورحمتك فإنه لا يملكها إلا أنت. اللهم يا ربنا اغفر لنا وارحمنا واهدنا السبيل الأقوم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين والآخرين والملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. صلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Inshallah.
بارك
الله فيك. جزاكم الله خيرا.
We'll see you next week.
We'll love you all for the sake of Allah. جزاكم الله خيرا.